Hey everyone, today I will show you how to take night stunning photo with your iPhone 15 Pro Max and also how to capture the Milky Way. Star photography with the iPhone 15 Pro Max can be a little bit more challenging, but with the right tool and technique, it's definitely possible to create stunning photo. Night photography is all about balancing light and shadows, and it requires a bit more thought and preparation than shooting during the day. However, the iPhone 15 Pro Max comes equipped with some incredible features that make it easier to get great results even in the dark. First, let's go over some essential tips for getting ready to take night photos. Choosing a location far from city lights to reduce light pollution and having a clear sky are crucial. So it's a good idea to check the weather forecast. Finding the Milky Way is not always an easy task. This is why I use an iPhone app, PhotoPills, to help me to find it. Now let's dive into how to use the night mode, which is one of the standout features of the iPhone 15 Pro Max for night photography. This feature allows you to capture more detail in low light by taking longer exposure, which means even in the dark, your photo can be sharp and bright. Before we continue, don't forget to subscribe, like, and add comment down below. This will be very appreciated. Thanks. First, open your camera app on your iPhone. Night mode activates automatically when the camera detects that the scene is dark enough. Look for the night mode icon at the top of the screen. It looks like a little moon. If it's yellow, that means the night mode is on and ready to use. If it's gray, night mode isn't activated, but you can manually turn it on. To manually activate night mode, just tap on the moon icon. You'll see a slider appear that lets you adjust the exposure time. Slide it to the right for a longer exposure, which is ideal for every dark scene, like the night sky. The iPhone will suggest an exposure time, but you can adjust it by dragging the slider. For night photography, I recommend setting to the maximum exposure time available, which can go up to 30 seconds. To get sharp photo, it is important to keep your iPhone steady while night mode is active. Using a tripod is the best way to ensure your shots stay sharp, especially during longer exposure. Also, to minimize the shake, when pressing the shutter button, you can use a remote shutter or the timer in the camera app. Another setting you should enable is Prores Raw, because this will record your photo in 10 bits, which will retain more information and dynamic range in the file. This will provide more flexibility when editing for the exposure and white balance. Okay, now the night mode is set up, we are ready to start capturing the night sky, in our case, the Milky Way. The next step is to think about how to compose our shot, which is key to creating a photo that is not just technically good, but also visually striking. I use PhotoPills to help me to find the best composition for the Milky Way. A good tip for composing your shot and to add depth and interest in your Milky Way photo is to include something in the foreground, like a tree, rock formation, or even a silhouette. This helps to create a sense of scale and make the image more dynamic. Also, when framing your shot, try to keep any source of light pollution like city light out of the frame. This will help to keep the sky as dark as possible, allowing the Milky Way to stand out. Now we have framed our shot with the Milky Way, we are ready to start shooting. I have my remote in my hand and I click my first shot. Before taking the next shot, I will look at the result. Maybe I will have to do some correction to the exposure, focus, or composition. Now I have my perfect shot. The next step, I will show you how I edit my photo to bring out the best in it. Okay, now we are ready to edit our photo. For the editing application, I will use Lightroom on my iPad. It's the same application than with the iPhone, so it's gonna be easier for you to follow me with all the settings. Okay, we are ready to start. The first thing I will check, I am in Apple Pro Raw. This is the setting we had with the iPhone when we did our picture. I adjust the lighting, lower the exposure just a little bit, raise the contrast. Raise the highlight, just to bring the star a little bit more. Drop the shadow to darken the sky. Raise the white. And drop down the black. Now I go with the color. I will adjust the tint. Try to remove a bit of green and bring more color to it. The temperature a little bit. Vibrance, just a little bit. And the saturation, I will put it down a little bit and raise the tint a little bit more. Now I go with the color mix with the yellow. I will lower the saturation and the luminance. Okay. In the effects tab, I will add a little bit of texture, the clarity. I raise up the eyes. This is the tool that makes the bigger difference. I will add some vignette. Seems to be okay. Now we are ready to save our picture. Just tap on it. Save a copy to device. Copy have been saved. I will go on my device. This is our picture. This is our image. It's pretty nice. I like it. Okay, that's it. We've gone through the entire process of capturing the Milky Way with our iPhone 15 Pro Max, from setting up the night mode on our iPhone, framing and setting the Milky Way, to editing our photo with Adobe Lightroom for iPad for the best possible result. Night photography could be a little bit challenging, but with practice, you'll get better and better at it. Thanks for joining me in this night photography adventure. If you want to see more video like this, check the link up here or in the description below. See you soon. Bye.